Now, to preview this poll and give us her take on the mood of the people in South Australia is columnist and host of the Ali Clarke Breakfast Show on Mix. Good to talk to you again, Ali. We haven't caught up for a long while. Tell us, what are the big issues there? Is it the pandemic? Does that dominate all in the election campaign, or is it about healthcare or this car race that's been scrapped?
Oh, I think increasingly the car race might be falling off the grid at the moment only because of the way that the attacks are laying out against each other. I think you hit the nail on the head, Chris, where you said you have to consider where this all started. And this very much, you know, compared to what we've seen interstate, we had a really successful COVID response. Now, that is obviously with the caveat of the victims and their families and also businesses who suffered, as you said, during tighter restrictions. So under that, during that, to protect himself almost, Premier Marshall handed over the responsibility to our Chief Public Health Officer and to Grant Stevens, the State Commissioner, but now he's had to wrest that back. So he's doing that now and trying to lead from the front and almost take credit without taking credit. Now, critics would say, or cynics, I should say, would say that the lifting of restrictions has timed itself quite nicely for the election itself. Just this weekend, we had density limits scrapped. We were out dancing, we were out partying in the middle of our Mad March and fringe festivals and WOMAD and everything else. So there's been a lot of good feeling in the streets of Adelaide just ahead of Saturday's Snagfest. So that has played out well. Now he, of course, has been questioned about that. And he said, well, no. We've always taken the health policy and we would never do that. So it may be just a coincidence. But he's got quite a few fires that he's trying to put out. Obviously, he's got the unions attacking him. The big thing here is still about our health system and ramping. In fact, just today, the Ambulance Association is putting the death of two people who are waiting for ambulances at the feet of the government. You have him having to work out what is going on within his own party, his moderate leadership versus the Conservatives that are causing a bit of ructions, and then what to do with the independents. There's no secret why he was splashing cash down in Mount Gambier with independent Conservative independent Troy Bell down there, and Carvel too with Dan Cregan up there. So he is coming back to trust in us. We got you through. We are fiscally responsible. The other guys aren't. We will be here for the longevity of your economic stability. So that's really what he's trying to hammer home, as well as maybe the party and the good mood that we're in at the moment.
Yeah, I tell you what, I'm heading down to Adelaide tomorrow. I can't wait because I know it's such a great time of year with the festival, the fringe and the footy starting on Sunday and great. And as you say, the restrictions are coming off. And it could be that Peter Malinauskas, the Labor leader, gets to inherit all that. And I think the problem with Stephen Marshall, of course, is people like me criticised him all along for being too strict with borders and lockdowns and the like. That's not because we want people to get COVID, but because, you know, you always have to open up. There always will be infections. He held out for so long, but now in the last 2 or 3 months, of course, you've had cases, you've had deaths. So give us a sense, Ali, whether it's hard to put a number on, isn't it, where people are. Some people think, great, he's finally moving on with life, but there will be some people saying, no, you made a mistake on opening the borders. Now we've got the disease.
Oh, there's no doubt. And he doesn't necessarily have the support that you would imagine a Liberal Premier would have from the top end of town and from business because of the restrictions that have been in place. And I wonder if we are now going to split a little bit into the haves and happy to have freedom and everything else and those that might feel very, very vulnerable and where their votes might sit. But then you do have Peter Malinauskas in all of this that has had to offer and has continued to offer that bipartisan support during, you know, what was that rather, you know, consolidated and successful COVID response, but now having to turn around and find other avenues to attack. So, yes, he is spending big or promising to spend big. He has, I think the government is trying to put about $3 billion worth of spending at his feet when we've come straight off the back with the greatest stimulus spending that we've seen, what, outside wartime. So now the division really seems to be between the government saying, trust us, these guys aren't responsible, we'll look after you, we've got you this far, and now Peter Malinauskas going, well, hang on a second, we're going to fix all the issues like the ramping, et cetera, et cetera. Malinauskas' issue with that is that it was the Labor government that, through Transforming Health, a lot of people think actually got us into that mess.
He's the candidate from Central Casting, is Peter Malinauskas, and he's aspirational. he's the sort of leader you want an opposition to present. Very quickly, Ali, tell us who wins, Stephen Marshall or Peter Malinauskas?
Oh, Man, do you know who's going to win the AFL footy season? You don't. I don't even know how to call this.
As you know, it's the year of the crow.
Well, we'll go with that. We'll go with the AFLW win first, I think, with the Crows.
Look, exactly.
I think minority government, and then it's going to come down to the how each side wrangles the independent.
Exactly.
I would have said Labor if you believe the polls, but polls have been wrong. But when it comes down to it, you walk in to that booth, 30% of you haven't made up a decision when you do that, and you sit there and you go, right, who actually has got us through what has been an incredibly tricky time in the last few years? Does that swing it back to Liberal and the government side? I don't know.
It could do. We'll find out on Saturday night. Thanks so much for joining us, Ali.
See you soon.